MRI stands for magnetic resonance imaging, and it is a technology that allows us to obtain detailed images of the internal organ. It allows an optimal contrast between soft tissues to be obtained. And for this reason, it's become one of the preferred methods of imaging the brain in particular. So when we talk about conventional MRI, we refer to the use of MRI to take detailed anatomical pictures of an organ, which is typically then reviewed by a radiologist who's able to tell whether there is something there that shouldn't be there or everything is normal. Quantitative MRI is slightly different because in this case we use MRI to try and measure properties of the tissue that otherwise would have to be measured by taking away a sample from the patient with all the associated risk and uncomfort. Part of my work is to try and, using a technical term, optimize the way of collecting data, which means trying to reduce the time we spend acquiring data, but to maintain the same quality so that it can one day be included in routine clinical examinations. And I'm also currently working on aims at quantifying myelin in the brain. Myelin is a special insulating material that is wrapped around our neurons and basically enables the transmission of a signal from the brain to the rest of the body to become efficient. And when myelin is damaged, the transmission from the brain to the rest of the body becomes impaired. One typical example is multiple sclerosis, which specifically attacks myelin, at least in the first phases of the disease. And so the ability of measuring or quantifying myelin non-invasively using MRI is of great potential. Quantitative MRI can really help in understanding what are the mechanisms of disease and how a disease evolves, and also monitor the effect of medications in patients.